Hi guys, here's Paola and I'm about to jump into this ozone sauna. But before I do, I'd like to address one thing that keeps coming up about heat and ozone and saunas. So we know that heat destroys ozone gas, and yet people combine those two things when doing ozone saunas. So does this even make sense? Won't the ozone just break down to oxygen right away? That's what I'm about to address in this video. But first, I want to thank everyone who has sent me a donation. You guys rock. Like, you are seriously the best. Like, Tina Turner type, you're simply the best! Better than all the rest! That type of the best. I think I honestly have the most generous supporters. I love you guys. For everyone who wants to join the fund, just go to thepowerofozone.com/donate and send me that dough, yo, so I can make more of the ozone video. Hello! So, let's get right to it. Does it make sense to do ozone saunas if ozone is destroyed by heat? So, yes, heat does destroy ozone. That's a well-established fact. The hotter it gets, the more ozone is broken down. And the colder it gets, the less ozone is broken down and the longer it survives. And yet, ozone saunas can be highly beneficial, as I have experienced numerous times in my life. So how is this possible? Well, number one, not all of the ozone is immediately destroyed. It takes some time for the gas to break down, even when it's really hot. Number two, during the sauna, you constantly add more ozone. So whatever ozone is being destroyed, it is also being substituted by new incoming ozone all the time. Number three, it works because the flow of the oxygen is relatively high. That is important when doing an ozone sauna. Remember, when you produce ozone, you need to first have oxygen. You can choose the speed with which the oxygen flows into the ozone generator, which is the same speed with which the produced ozone flows out of the generator and into the sauna. And one should choose a relatively high oxygen flow to quickly supply new ozone gas to make up for the just destroyed gas. So you want a constant high inflow of new ozone molecules. And you achieve that by setting a high oxygen flow. The setting I recommend when doing ozone saunas is 1/4 to 0.5 liter per minute. That's relatively high for ozone applications. And it's the reason why I recommend using an oxygen concentrator instead of an oxygen tank for saunas, because that way you never run out of oxygen. What I noticed though is that this question about ozone saunas being possibly useless because of heat destroying the gas only comes up among people who have never done an ozone sauna, because anyone who has knows that this simply does not happen. How do they know? Because when you step out of the sauna at the end of the session, a lot of ozone escapes. You will smell that. At that point, there's actually so much ozone around that one should be careful when getting out. That's why I always recommend wearing a mask, because you do not want to breathe it in. So this fact alone completely destroys the argument that ozone does not survive the high temperatures. Also, while you're sitting in the sauna, you will smell the ozone escape through the neck hole. That's why it's so important to put a towel around your neck and wear the mask. And additionally, even put a fan in front of you, simply because there's so much ozone around. So yes, heat does destroy ozone, but if the settings are chosen correctly, there's still plenty of gas around to do its magic. And you don't have to believe a single word I'm saying. Just do an ozone sauna and you will see for yourself. Ozone saunas, by the way, are great for any type of injuries. So if you don't believe me, all you need to do is just get run over by a car and then jump into the sauna and then you'll see. Easy peasy. In general, I think that ozone saunas seem to be highly undervalued, which is a pity because I think they're a great alternative to intravenous ozone. They can be a very powerful systemic treatment. They're not invasive and you can do them at home for relatively low cost without needing to get any special accessories like needles or anticoagulants. So I'll be jumping in here. If you want to know which equipment I'm using for my ozone sauna, just check out the description below the video. That's it for now, guys. Don't forget to eat a steak afterwards. Be human, eat meat. See ya. And remember not to take anything I've said here as medical advice.